Forward and backward searching using citation searches for literature reviews. In this tutorial, we'll define citation searching in bibliographic mining. We'll show how these techniques contribute to a literature review. We'll also experiment with citation searching using a variety of databases. Think about a research article you find as part of an ongoing conversation among researchers. That research article represents one researcher's ideas and findings at a given point in time. Citation searching allows you to use that article to trace the history of an idea both backwards and forwards in time. Using the strategies we demonstrate in this tutorial, you'll find additional resources for your literature review. Let's begin with bibliographic mining. You may already be using this strategy. When you review the reference list at the end of an article and find additional resources that interest you, this is called bibliographic mining. These articles will be older than the article you have in hand. This technique is sometimes called backward searching because you are looking into the past and finding sources of information that influenced or contributed to the author's work in some way. Some ProQuest and EBSCO databases include the cited references in the results list view. These will link you directly to the articles in the original article's bibliography. If you have an article that does not have a cited references feature, you may use Research at UW-Whitewater to locate the articles on its reference list. For the most results, be sure to sign in and click the Search Beyond UW-Whitewater button. You may have to search for the article in a number of databases, or you might also try Google Scholar, along with the Find It at UW-Whitewater link. What about more recent research? Forward searching allows you to find newer sources on your topic that build on your original article. When you forward search, you begin with an article, then look for links in the database that say cited by, cited reference, or time cited. The results list shows books or articles that have included your original article in their bibliographies. When searching for articles in research at UW-Whitewater, some but not all may have one or both of these icons. One indicates find sources citing this, that is, forward searching. The other indicates find sources cited in this, that is, find sources in its bibliography. Some other library databases have a times cited in this database link in the results view. Here are a few more examples of what to look for. Google Scholar results sometimes have two cited by links, one that counts the citations included in Scholar's database, the other that counts the citations in the Web of Science database. You'll notice that one article's cited by number will be slightly different in every place we check. That's because each search tool can only count the citations that it contains in its own database. Using a cited reference search, you can learn how research has been confirmed, improved, corrected, applied, or extended. Citation searching can be a clue as to how influential or important an article is. Usually, the higher the number of sources in the cited by or time cited list, the greater the impact the original source has made on the field. Often, being highly cited is an indication of high quality, but not always. A particular idea or article might be highly controversial, or one article might cite an article to refute another author's findings or methods. Without reviewing the articles citing the original source, you may not see that the methodology or conclusions are being challenged. Just because an article hasn't been cited doesn't mean it won't be notable. The article might simply be too new to have been cited, or it might not even be very notable. As you dive deeper into your literature review, consider employing the search strategies of bibliographic mining and citation searching. They can help you understand the ongoing conversation around a research topic. Don't hesitate to contact the library with any questions.